concept. Okay?
Arguments happen over
reasons on a more or less daily basis or frequently. Single parenting, parents going through divorce, parents are separated, raised by single parents, and lot of other problems, alcohol, smoking, any other addictions, all these things, and these are the common factors. So we have to also look at when you are working with a particular group of children, it might differ with each group. You know, the urban kind of scenario is different. When you look at the rural kind of scenario, specifically a particular area, it will be different. So we have to always consider them as social factors. So, equal amount of social factors, any one of you can give me an idea what kind of social factors or home-related factors that can influence the children being studying here. Ikkada, one of the grammars in which are they a kind of family factors might be coming in there. Low evidence.
Lack of affection.
Lack of affection. Similarity is there, lack of affection is there.
Alcoholism
is there.
Almost
all factors are there.
Poverty
is there. So, high noise levels, arguments. So, apologies and almost what we are looking at. Okay. So, coming to school related factors. Okay. As teachers, school related factors and they mean the way that you relate to the students. And it also covers a bit of the kind of curriculum that you teach, whether it is following a particular stream, like say kids in a particular locality might be more into a kind of a particular vocational kind of occupational, where the curriculum has to be molded according to their needs. But if you are following a particular standardized curriculum, then how much it is practically viable for them as they move on into their higher education. So if more and more evidence is suggesting on the people from their lower class itself, you can make out what they are more interested in. Some of them are not good at maths, they can't think of making them into BSc maths or LSc maths, right? So, then it will be like a parental thing that we are forcing on them. So kids always express what they are good at, what they are interested in. So here the teacher's role comes in picture where, you know, the teacher is the person who can identify what a particular child is good at. Some might be very good at arts, some might be very good at science, some might be very good at practical, not so much in expression, maybe they are more good at practicals. Some might be very good with languages. So that is just on how we, you know, focus. So I'm not very good at maths. So I somehow passed my math. I don't know how I passed. So if I have to, you know, help the children having maths issues, I will not be the right person. Right? So, but I may be good at language, I may be good at arts. So some of the teachers are more good with arts, some of the teachers are more good with, apart from your training also. Maybe you are trained in a particular field or particular, faculty, but still, you know, I always felt that my father is a doctor, so everybody is a doctor, so my father also wanted me to become a doctor. But I don't know what I have to do. Neither I am clear that I want to become a doctor. So it took me almost 20 plus years to figure out what I am good at. But these days, kids are exposed to a lot of media environment where they can pick those interests much faster. Even though we are saying that there are technological or technology-related flaws or addictions happening, if you look at the positive side of it, you can easily make out what the child is good at. So, if as a teacher, if you can nourish that, okay. If they are good at art, can we look at something forward in that? If the child is good at maths, is there something that we can look at forward? Right? Which is more more in terms of formal education. So clinically, when kids come to our clinic, there is a three-wish test that we ask. You can also do it. If you ask your child what are the three wishes that they have, so child will, you know, tell what they want. Some might tell, I want a cycle, or some might tell, I want my parents to be happy. They might tell, but they tell honestly what they want. So we have to nourish. What is that you are good at? How you can make that as? It's very easy when you do something that you like. Like a lifelong career, you don't put so much of extra effort, right? It's like you are doing what you are good at. You actually are your best when you are doing something that you are good at. So that is the kind of environment only a teacher can give. So the kind of relation that you share with the teachers or with the students is very, very important to figure out what they are good at right from the lower classes. So school related, the way you relate to your students, and it's not always the blackboard teaching or teaching using the gadgets. So it's more like a kind of involving the children, a lot of participation of the children. Like say that if you want, tomorrow you are teaching a lesson on plant or something like that. So it's always better that they're learning from the textbooks rather than the notes that you give them. See, notes is always planned towards a particular mode of preparation for your exams, things like that. So child has to be reading a textbook right from childhood. That's very important, the kind of habit that you're doing. So tomorrow if you're teaching a particular class, then don't just go over it. They may not understand fully, it doesn't matter, but at least the child has this feeling of being able to read the textbook. And then it actually broadens their view when you are actually teaching. How much you can teach in a class is always limited. It is always restricted to the time that you are given, or it's the time that you need to cover according to the syllabus or all that. But once the child gets this habit of going to the textbook, as they are moving on towards middle school and higher classes, it makes them much more broader in the way that they can use it more creatively. They can look at from much more not on the boundaries of only this particular question. If anything is given beyond that, they don't know how to write. Even though they know the answer, they don't know how to write. So, the textbooks, chalavadam anedi, the earlier that you introduce to the children, the better it helps them. So, how you teach, the teaching methodology, all that, you can also involve the children, you can tell the children, you prepare this particular topic today for the first time. Doesn't matter, the child may be telling a sentence or two sentences, but at least the child has this confidence of presenting. The presentation skills, all these things, the classroom is the best place. So what I do with children who are shy and who are not socially proficient, I actually give them a small topic, and this is what we do in our life skills. So afternoon session or a little later, we have a little bit of practical way of how you can, as a teacher, how you can bring in different concepts. For kids, you can't always give a lot of theory, right? So as adults, we can read it, we can go through the theory. But for the children to understand the particular concept, they need a kind of role play, skits lava, role play lava, drama lava, different painting methods, art therapy lava. You do all that, so that you have a clear idea of what you can try with your kids. So, how you can make them a better, confident people. Give them a topic of 5 minutes. Talk about, let us say, you're celebrating some festival. Santrati. Tell a couple of kids to come and present what is Santrati. What do we do? Where do we celebrate? So that will help them to become more confident. The facing people is something that they have to do. That's part of the training. So when they are able to do it, someone comfortable, the teacher, they are seeing every day. So it's easy for them when they go out, if they have to assert, if they have to speak of something. It's very important. It's all starts. You will be the person who is the budding factor for the children to open up all these things. So for them, children speak from their heart. They don't have too many inhibitions. It's speaking to tell them that, oh, you should not say this, you should not say this, you have to behave like this, you have to be like this. Manamukkolani, we narrow their way of thinking, but actually they are more creative and they are more broader in the way that we look at. So, as school teachers, it's important that not only we are restricting the class PCRD, I know all the syllabus I know, you got to be like the syllabus I know. So, if you are looking at that way of mode, then we are only making our children more tense. Okay, it's only the child. The grade of stress from this day. But is it helping the child grow as a person? So, then separate from the Jain and Field. The way that you are teaching, the way that you are interacting with the students, the way that you are introducing different topics, and the way that you can also use the personality development. You don't have to separate the personality development course that I can take every day. So, this is what school. Your attitude, your attitude towards teaching, your involvement with the parents. Let's say that you're seeing some child is very destructive or very distracted, not able to attend the class. It's always important to give a child a gift. To ask them, not in the class separately, you ask them to come with them. It's free time, any day, what is the problem? Something is bothering you. A little bit of talk. You may not be a problem solver for them. So, from problem solving, when they move, we have to empty themselves. It can be a small discomfort. It can be something the child did not see. It can be something the child is worried about back home. It can be anything. It can be anything that the child is sensitive or simple kind of factors. Maybe not well, maybe headache, maybe stomachache. We don't know. A lot of issues can bother teenagers, especially the 8, 9, 10. And they can become very moody. They can suddenly, become frustrated and then they will be occupied with all of things. So, functional, personal love, whoever is the class teacher, can be a different experience, same idea, what happened? Is there something bothering you? Anything? Is there anything that we can do at our level? Everyone need not be a full-fledged counselor, right? So, we are all counselors. We all do. But we are given an idea, what do we tell? Counseling is nothing but. So, we tell them. Counseling is more like thinking from a much more broader perspective. So in a way we are all counselors. Separate counselor and undergraduate. So one of the role of a teacher is also counselor. One of the role of counselor is also a teacher. So in our sambandham ledu naaku theriyadu. So you are all introduced, those who have done B.Ed. Psychology is one part of the year, right? So we do a lot of projects or some work related to psychology. Yes? Yeah. So, child development can be a child goes. What are the psychological needs of the child? Different age group. Pre-primary and original level, 0-5 years, 6 years. So maybe the focus is on language development, a lot of languages, artwork. So, pillarly language, provide we don't know how much, the kind of environment we have to control. 7 hours, 8 hours, kids are with us. So, art is the best medium of developing their language. Children, first standard, second standard, what they could have. So, you can just tell them. So, anything you do, you may not always be either modern to see the AI or to. We have imagination, chala, warm up to. So, anything that they can draw, they can think of, you know, genuinely. Let us say a simple example would be like you're seeing any child being in a little room, at a thing or a room, just as long. The best way is give them a couple of colors, give them a pencil, couple of colors, and a paper. Aim up on the mind, you're going to draw in me. Chalo, this is all you need to do. And you can easily make out what's bothering the child. We'll do that practice. Okay, it will be a kind of exercise for you also. So when you are putting your mind, chalo vishayam language lo cheppandi, communication lo cheppaledi, we can tell an art form. You don't have to be skilled in doing sketching or that's not what we are looking at. We are looking at how we can use that art medium as a way of expressing your feelings. Sad company, okay. Someone is teasing, kids are going through some teasing. So we express, they may not do a human figure perfectly. They can just put around their just a simple figure. At least what we understand that someone is bothering the child. Something is bothering the child. So if you are allowed within a sign from written of their own very income, you draw it. You tell the child might draw something. You can always make out what angel, you may not infer anything. You can even draw this, I don't know which of you, and a child, it just comes over there, saying the Indian. The Chapaguru and Anandar, right, it is a more true art. That's what we want to tell children. And you can draw language limitation from the art, you will be the best in you. Art, until we don't have to only think only drawing. Can be anything, art material, reading power to, drawing power to, skit formula power to, repertoire, I mean, all the different ways you can write the piece later session. So, that's the whole of your feature. So, a lot of things that you can make a difference in that 6 hours, 7, 8 hours that the kids are here. Because you don't have a complete control of what's happening at home. Right? So most of the times children may not have language to express also, especially if you look at below 10 years kids. So a lot of times they may not be understanding what's happening at home. They may not have enough language to tell it. Sadga, frustration, they can't express like an adult can express it. So if I look at most of my clients who are coming to my clinic or my center, even our own express theory, frustration express theory, and a problem express theory, a lot of the times we don't have the language to express it. Because we have never, as a children, we never encourage children to express what they are problem. No? So, our active idea is that we don't have any problems with them already. That's how we brush off, right? That's how we brush off. But they think a lot. Children keep having a stable emotional environment, something that happens on a daily basis, routine laga, something that repeats, something for the routine laga, for the predictability and predictability. I can expect this from my mother, I can expect this from my father. But they are talking on the very particular matter. Friendly one day teacher to bring a man out there, serious one day teacher to bring a man out there. Kids can easily make out how they can. So friendly one, open one, to automatically be a free flowing one, and the chimpest one, the mind one. So the more you maintain that seriousness, the more you maintain that when teacher rely on that, you have to be like this only, you have to maintain this kind of, attitude, then work with enemies, at least with the enemies. So, you have to be a participant with the kids. Only then you can make out what's bothering the child. Okay? So, allow to play as a teacher. So, let's quickly look at the psychological and health factors because more and more scientific research is focused on. These are the major causes, psychological as well as health-related factors. Clearly, it may or may not apply to the children here, but most of the research is focused on these factors, because of the changing moment, changing scenarios, changing social value system. So a lot of research. Let's quickly look at this, and then we'll see. I want to, at least each one of you ask one person that is relevant to your case. Okay? So that everyone are comfortable with me, because we'll have to see each other's face for a long time. We are hoping to come back. It's not like I want to come for one time. So we are wanting to come, and then so it's easy that, you know, we become friends rather than, you know, trying to make prepare one person in your mind so that we can make it much more participative and dynamic. Okay? So quickly looking at what is the psychological factors, maybe we look at